Hello everyone, welcome back to CAT Tutorials for Beginners. In this tutorial we are going to start learning the transformation features in CATIA V5 part design. So till now we have already learned the sketch based features as well as the dress up features in the earlier tutorials. If you have not watched those videos, you can go back in the playlist and you can watch those videos for your better understanding. So let's start with the patterns in the transformation features in this tutorial. So once you click on the drop down menu, you can see there are different types of patterns available in CATIA V5. So first one is a rectangular pattern, second one is a circular pattern, and third one is a user pattern. So in this tutorial we will discuss about the circular pattern in detail. So let's create the features over here and we will make use of them to pattern it. So let's create circular profile here and provide the diameter of that circle, let's say 200 mm, and I will just add the material with a pad command. And another feature I will create on this top face, and again I will create the circle over here. So you can just use and you can create any of the features, any of the profile type, let's say 25 mm, and here again we will provide the distance of it, let's say 50 mm, and exit this workbench. Again use the pad command to add the material and click on OK. So now we have these two features ready, pad 1 and pad 2, and we will make use of this pad 2 and we will create a circular pattern with the use of it. So now you can see the transformation features options are visible, and just click on the drop down and select the circular pattern. And now once you click on the circular pattern, the dialog box pops up, and in this you can see the two tabs available, axial difference reference and the crown definition. So here in the parameters tab you can see there are different types of parameters types over here. And once you select the specific parameter type, we need to provide the values for that parameters in the down spaces. Okay, so you can see if you select the instance and total angle, you have to provide the instances and the total angle over here. If you select the instance and angular spacing, you need to provide the instances and the angular spacing. The third parameter value is computed by the CATIA V5 depending upon these two parameters. After that you need to provide the reference direction, that can be the axis or the you can create a line, whatever it is. And below that we need to provide the objects which need to be patterned. So once you click on the more option, you can see there are different options available here. We will see in this later part of this video. So just select the first type over here, that is the instances and the total angle. And now we'll add the instances, let's say 3 instances, and we'll provide the total angle of 60 degrees. And you can see here the angular spacing is automatically calculated by the CATIA V5. So if you add the 3 instances, the total angle will be 60 degrees, and the angular spacing between the each of the instance will be 30 degrees. And here we'll select the object which need to be patterned. You can directly select in the specification tree, or you can select in the directly on the object. Just select this, and here we need to provide the reference. You can just right click on it and select the Z axis. So around Z axis we need to create that pattern. So if you click on OK, you can see the pattern is created. Again, if you want to change or modify the pattern, you can just double click on it and you can just increase this total angle, let's say 180 degrees, and click on OK. So in this way you can use this type of parameter, and you can see the angular spacing is 90 degrees, which is automatically computed by the CATIA. The second type is instances and the angular spacing. So here we need to provide the instances and the angular spacing. So again, if you preview it, you will get the, just I will increase this to 4 instances, and angular spacing is 90 degree, so the total angle is all automatically computed by CATIA. Just click on preview and the pattern is created. So the third option is angular spacing and the total angle. So here we need to provide the total angle and the angular spacing, so it will automatically compute the total instances. So let's say 45 degree, and you can see the instances is increased to 7. Just click on OK. In this way you can use these different parameters. Complete cron, so it will select the complete cron over here, and the total angle will be 360 degree, and here you can just provide the instances, whichever amount of instances you require, and in this way this pattern is created. Again double click on it to modify, and the last option is the instances and the unequal angular spacing. So here let's say I will reduce these instances to 5, and again click on preview, and here I will increase it to 35 degree, or let's increase it to 60 degree. Just click on OK. So now if you want to change this to unequal spacing over here, you can just change it here as well. So let's add 45 degree, and it will create an unequal spacing. So in this way you can create this, let's say 70 degree, and in this way you can customize your circular pattern depending upon the requirement. So in this way these are the parameter types, and this keep specification option we will understand with the help of another example. Here the option available is reverse. So again, if you want to reverse this direction of the pattern, so use this option to reverse it. You can see the pattern is reversed on the, and it will start from the another direction. So you can see here the direction, this is arrow 1, this is the first instance, and this is the second instance. So this is the original one, and this is the first instance. So if you don't want to see any of the specific instance, you can just double click on this dot, you can just double click on it, and you can see it is not showing in this pattern now. And once you click on OK, that instance will not be seen in this body. So again, if you double click on it, it will be turned back into the pattern. So this is the useful option available in this pattern. So I will just select the complete cron option and create a 5 instances. So again double click on it to modify, and here in the cron definition again we can have these 3 parameter types. So we can have the circle and the cron thickness. So depending upon the parameters selected, we have to provide the values, parameter values. So we can have the circle 1 and the cron thickness is 0. So let's try to increase this circle 2, and the thickness you can increase. So you can see this cron like structure is created depending upon this thickness. So this thickness is nothing but the distance between this circle's centers. So as we know, you can see this circle radius of 20, circle diameter of 25 mm, and this is also most definitely will be the 25 mm diameter, and the distance between these two centers will be 25 mm. So again, if you want to hide any of the instance, you can just hide, just click on it, and it will be hided. So in this way you can use of these options as well. Again, if you want to provide the different parameters, circles and the circle spacing, then again you can provide it with the help of this example. The last one is the circle spacing and the cron thickness. So again, depending on the two parameters, this circle's numbers will be computed. So this is a cron like crown like structure we are getting with the help of this example. So I'll just select the crown thickness, and here I will add, let's say, 3 circles, and the crown thickness I will add over here is 15. So you can see the pattern is created. As the distance is less than the distance between the two circles centers, again if you increase it beyond 25, then it will create a 3 touching circles. Just click on OK and it will create a circle. Just click on OK. Again, I will add just, let's say, 55 mm and click on OK. So in this way, you can create a pattern. And now we will see how this key specification options can be used. I will just delete this pattern first, or you can just make it deactivate. Again, I will just make this as also deactivate. Sorry. So better we'll just delete it. Actually, we don't need it. So again, I will create. So before going to that option, we are going to understand the another option in the more tab, that is the radial alignment of instances. So just cancel it, and here we'll create another type of feature, that is rectangular feature instead of the circular feature. So here use this rectangular shape and exit this workbench and create a pad over it. And now we will make a circular pattern of this feature. So again, click on the circular pattern, select this object to pattern, and here we'll use this complete crown option, and the reference will select the Z axis, and in the crown tab we'll just make it to 1. And now, as you can see, once you click on OK, you can see the orientation of this feature. So if you don't want this type of orientation over here, just click, go on to the more tab, and if you need the orientation as the original one, then you can just uncheck this option, radial alignment of instances, and click on OK. So this option align the object orientation. So again, double click on it, and if you want to orient this or orient this feature as per the circular pattern, then you have to just check this option and click on OK. So this is the use of this option. And again, in the more tab, you can see the simplified representation here. So simplified representation lightens the pattern geometry. Just click on OK. And again, if you double click on it, if you just want to hide this, you can just hide it over here. Just click on OK. Now we will understand this option, that is keep specification option. So actually there is one more option available here, the rotation angle. So if you want to add some of the rotation angle for the instances, you can use of this option as well for this. Let's say if you want to start this instances from 30 degree, then you can add this 30 degree over here. So this is one more important option available in the circular pattern. So I will just delete this complete features, and we will create one more feature over here to understand this option, that is keep specification. So as you can see, I have these features created over here, and now I will create one more feature on this top face. So just create a circular feature over here. So create a circular feature and just exit this of any size you can create. And now I will make use of this pad option, and here instead of this value, we will provide the up to next option. So up to next option will pad this circle till the next object, next face. So just click on OK. So now we will create a pattern of this. Just again go to the circular pattern and now select the body as a object to pattern, and here the axis you can also provide this face for the circle. And now you can see, if you click on the preview option, so you can see the pattern is created with the same length of this pad. But if you want to create a pattern of this pad length, keeping the limit type as up to next, then you have to select this keep specification options. So once you click on this keep specification option, the pad is created only till this face. And just click on OK. So now you can see the pad is created only till this surface. So this is the use of keep specification option in CATIA V5. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you have enjoyed watching it. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel for such more informative videos. Also click on the bell icon to get the notification updates. Thank you. Thank you for watching.